left school around 4th hour on Tuesday, April 24th, 2018. We drove down to Grand Rapids and got to the Gerald R. Ford International Airport. We got all of our luggage off of our buses and then checked our bags and went off to our gate to wait for our plane to take us to Baltimore, Maryland. Once our plane arrived, we boarded and then took off. Our flight was pretty short, less than 2 hours. When we got to Baltimore, it was a little cool and rainy. After our flight landed, we got dinner at the airport and then drove off to our hotel. We were staying in Bethesda, Maryland, which is a little bit outside of D.C. The next morning, we got up bright and early and started driving into D.C. for our first full day of touring. Our first stop was the Ford Theater in the Peterson House. I learned that Abraham Lincoln died in the Peterson House after he was assassinated in Ford Theater during his presidency. After we went to the Ford Theater Museum, we went into the actual theater and saw the booth where President Abraham Lincoln got shot. After that, we started walking down to the National Archives, which is where they keep the Constitution and Declaration of Independence. It was super cool to see them in real life. We then went to the National Air and Space Museum. It was a super fun museum to go to because there were many exhibits and lots of cool facts to learn there. This exhibit was about how astronauts live in space and what tools they need to survive. We then went to the White House, which is a really cool photo opportunity, but in real life, it's actually a lot smaller than you think. After lunch, we went to the National Cathedral. It was fascinating to learn about all the Gothic architecture, but one thing we learned was that the National Cathedral had suffered from an earthquake a few years ago and had over $30 million in damage. There was so much damage that even when we went, parts of the cathedral were still under construction. That night after dinner, we walked to many different memorials. The first one we visited was the Martin Luther King Memorial. We then continued on to the Franklin Delano Roosevelt Memorial. It is one of the largest memorials in all of DC. We then went to the Thomas Jefferson Memorial. We learned that the Thomas Jefferson Memorial was actually dedicated to Thomas Jefferson by FDR more than 74 years ago. We went right after the sunset, so it was super pretty to sit out on the steps and look at Washington, DC. Our last stop of the day was the Iwo Jima Memorial. After that, we headed back to the hotel. Our first stop on our second day was Arlington National Cemetery. We got to witness the changing of the guard, which was very interesting, and walk around the cemetery. We learned that over 400,000 people are buried in Arlington National Cemetery, including President John F. Kennedy and his family. One of my favorite places at Arlington was the amphitheater. It was so beautiful, and all the architecture was very intricate. On our way to the Capitol building, we saw the Anne Frank tree, which is a sapling from the chestnut tree that Anne Frank always used to look at when she was hiding in her annex. When we got to the Capitol building, it was super cool because you always see it in pictures, and being there in real life is pretty amazing. We then continued on to the Supreme Court building. For lunch that day, we went to Union Station, which is the main train station in Washington, D.C. It has a beautiful interior and was super fun to go to. We then went to the Vietnam Memorial, which was very sad because it had all of the names of the soldiers who died in Vietnam. We continued on to the Korean Memorial, which was very interesting because it almost looked like all those statues were looking at you. We then went to the Abraham Lincoln Memorial, which was very beautiful because when you turned, you could look out over the reflecting pond and see the Washington Monument. We learned that the Abraham Lincoln statue was sculpted to show that half of his body was tense and the other half was at peace. We learned that Martin Luther King Jr. gave his I Have a Dream speech on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial. It was amazing to stand right where he once stood. We then continued on to the United States Holocaust Museum. It was a very devastating museum, but also full of information. In the museum, you get a booklet giving you the background on a person who lived during the Holocaust. The Holocaust Museum was designed so that it was spread out onto a few floors. You start on the first floor, which is the time leading up to the Holocaust and what events caused it. These are books that were burned and banned by the Nazis. In this room, there are many photographs, which is devastating because it shows all of the families, children, and adults that died during the Holocaust. Although the Holocaust Museum is a very sad place, it is a must-see when you go to Washington, D.C. because of all the history that is inside of it. Our last stop of the day was the Pentagon Memorial. I thought it was such a cool place because of all the detail put into it. On our last day, before we headed off to the airport, we went to George Washington's house, Mount Vernon. It was beautiful there with all of the rolling hills and the view of the Potomac River. The inside tour of his house was amazing because you got to see where George Washington actually lived. There were many beautiful trails around his estate as well, which was probably one of my favorite parts. We also learned that George Washington had many slaves and that some were still being discovered. After that, we headed back to the airport, getting ready to go back to Traverse City. Overall, my favorite part of the trip was probably walking around to all of the memorials and having such a fun time with my friends. I would definitely recommend going to Washington, D.C. for everyone. It was such a fun experience, and I will never forget it.